Hi, this is Steve Friederang from competitiveswimmer.com, and I wanted to show you how our tracking works. And this is, you know, more theoretical or more metaphorical than it is exact. In other words, if you want to change any part of this, you know, please feel free. In fact, this is kind of broken apart, as you can kind of see anyway. So I want to show you how tracking works. We can help you be able to get tracking. This will be in Cool Coach 5. Bridger Bell and I are working on that together. In Cool Coach, those of you who are familiar with that, was a software program we built literally back in the 1990s and early 2000s to be able to organize, help coaches to be able to organize, and I think most important, motivate their swimmers to be able to do things that they needed to do in order to, for them to reach their goals. We've already done a video this morning. This is part of a Zoom that Bridger and I are doing that showed goal setting and the goal card, the interactive goal card. And this is kind of where some of the things hit the road as far as being able to reach those goals. So what we've done is along here, we can put any name. Let's try that. Any name. So let's just go John Smith, right? Any one of your swimmers. And in the Cool Coach app, this will, you know, kind of populate for you. And in the Competitive Swimmer app right now, you can see some of this stuff, especially when it comes to dry land exercises and other kind of thing. We will actually connect all of these things together for you at some point within the app. But right now, with an Excel spreadsheet, you can do this. You can do it in Bridger's app. He'll probably talk about that during my Zoom. But there are other apps that can do these kinds of things. But I want to give you an idea of how to use it from a motivational standpoint, and also to be able to tell you how much that you need to have a lot of the control. And so we'll show you how to do that. So in this case, what we've done is, okay, you saw me change the name, and this is maybe her best time, his best time. These are actual numbers from some swimmers I've had, and I've kind of pieced it together for you this morning. What we have here, for example, is here's a set that I like doing 300-400 IMs on 8. We normally do it on 730, but this was on 8 for some slower swimmers. You see this is a averaging 457. The cool thing about it isn't that they go 457 on this set, but that in September of 2019, they went 530. The John here we just made up is going 539. So you average 539 on the set. And a lot of times when I'll come into a new team or mentor a team that doesn't have much endurance background, I might do this kind of max VO2 set where they try to get them to go as fast as they can three times and see what they can handle and work out. This one's a little bit long for some people, short for some people, whatever. Again, the point of this whole thing is that you can make it what you want it to be. And that's kind of the point we're trying to make. So what's really cool, though, is if you post this on a wall or you put it in a newsletter, which I often did, I would find a way to make a sheet that was the size of something I could print on an 8.5 by 11. A lot of times what I do is print this in 4 pages and then tape them together and put them on the wall so I didn't have to hand write them down or whatever. You can move the names anywhere you want to. You know, you can move this cell wherever you want to, or you can copy this cell and move it over here so you have it like every 10 or something so you can still see the names. Whatever you want to do, you can split the screen and make it scroll. Excel does all of that great stuff. But the point here is that everyone has a chance to win. And that's kind of what we're talking about when we're talking about tracking, is we want to control the environment. That's the job of the coach, to make an environment where people are most likely to be successful. And we need to make adjustments, sometimes on the fly, or sometimes to fly. Here's 3x400 fly. Obviously, we've thrown some stuff out here to give you an example of what we can do. I tried to not to make this look like an app, or like not to make it perfect right now, so that you can get the idea that you want to make sure that whatever you're doing to control the environment is working, but you want to make sure you can change it when you need to. Now, the one thing about consistency is, just to give you a background of how to do this that engages swimmers, is if my swimmer goes 300-400 IMs, well, let's give an easier example for you. Let's go, or for me, let's go, let's say, yeah, 3 100 breaststrokes. And so they averaged 109. They used to average 117. This is a tremendous drop for this swimmer. And there's hundreds of ways they could have made this drop happen. One, you know, with age group coaches, a lot of times they think they're being successful because they haven't compared to other teams doing this. And maybe they are. Maybe they are the most successful team in improving the 100 breaststroke time or the 200 breaststroke time. In this case, is sort of predicting the 200 breaststroke time in this set. 3 100s on 3 minutes. I like doing it. Some people like to use 8 minutes. Some people like to use 2 minutes. Whatever you want to do is fine. But the way to compare whether or not you're being successful is how much do your swimmers on average improve, or how close do they get to doubling a shorter time. So, for example, let's say this swimmer's best time is 105, and so if you double that, you get 210, right? So that would be, if they didn't slow down at all, they would get 210 on the 200. Well, what we found over time is that great teams are teams that usually, on the average, and again, you're going to have those people that are more genetically sprint-oriented and have a stroke that's more sprint-oriented and can't hold it for two. You know, there's a really famous one, Adam Peaty, right, who's really great at the 100. No one can beat him at the 100, but he really doesn't have the two to the level that most of us might think. Maybe he's doing it right. Maybe he's doing more 50s and 25s and doesn't train the 200. Or maybe his stroke is so unique to the 100 breaststroke that it doesn't work for the 200 breaststroke as well. But on average, what we found over time is that teams that are well-trained, where swimmers are reaching their more of their potential based upon their own goals, is our teams where that drop-off rate, we call it, is controlled. I'm about ready to sneeze. I'm allergic to grass. And I mowed the lawn. Okay, there we go. All right, so I'm glad this is live. Okay, so what we're going to do is, maybe Bridget can edit that. Anyway, thank you. This 3 100s on 3 minutes, it's a huge improvement. And what we're looking for here is improvement. So everyone can win this race. And this person started with a 117, but they're a 15% improvement. They averaged 129 at the beginning of the season, September of 2009 in this example. And now, whatever now is, and I didn't even put the date, I don't keep this that way. When I'm doing this chart, when I'm training this, I don't want to know week by week. I want to know how you're doing when I test it. Now, I'm a little careful about how I test it, but there are times when, man, no one's improving. And that pretty much tells me as a coach, well, I've got them kind of overdone, you know, in that area. I really shouldn't have tried a lactate set on that day. And that's a really good indication to me is how to change my cycle or how to change my weekly plan so that, okay, I'm going to let them have a couple days without high lactate before I test this again. I'm going to work on their stroke. I'm going to work on their turns. I'm going to work on all the things that are going to try to improve this. And then I'm going to get them to get up out of the pool. Now, here's what I do is I think the swimmer should be able to memorize what they're doing on this. They may not think so. So what I do is I print this up on a wall, and especially on a nice cold day, if they don't have their time, don't know their time going into the set, if I ask them, what's your time, and I have it in front of me, I ask them to get out of the pool and go check it out. We're recording here. So what I want to do is make sure that each of these swimmers knows their times before the set begins, because we have this saying in swimming, never leave a wall without a goal. Never leave a wall without a goal. So we want to make sure that they know before they start the set that their best time on the average on this set was 117. So if they go the first one and they go a 116, hey, they're in there. They're in there to improve. Shaking it off, stretch in between, you know, look at how everybody else is doing, talk it out, have me yell at them, whatever. And then they try it again. Maybe they go a 115, you know, and they get more and more excited. So that's how you use this kind of a tracking system to control your environment. And again, I keep saying it, but I want to make sure you realize it. Just because I'm doing it doesn't mean it's the way that it has to be done. Your team may be different. The personality of your team may be somewhat different. However, there are some principles. If you're the kind of coach that comes in there without any plan at all every single day, I think you're going to have, and you start to do this, you're going to have to think about something that's going to be remarkable. You're going to have to think about telling them to slow down. You're going to have to tighten the intervals so they can't go so fast every single day or they're going to fry themselves. And they will do that. When they're trying to beat each other and they're trying to beat these percentage improvements for themselves, they're going to be highly motivated. And I've seen it a million times as a mentor coach that you know, these things absolutely do work. And if it doesn't work, again, you just change it. You just go up here and change it. Now, remember, Excel is sort of brainless. It doesn't know if this is 3 100s fly on three or push-ups or wall push-ups or whatever. As long as you can measure it, then you can make sure that you can put it in here and they can be rewarded for it. And I think that's kind of the big thing. It's a reward system. It's so highly motivating that really swimmers are willing to do just about anything for me. I've had swimmers go a 16 mile IM long course at 5,000 feet for time. We had a girl that led the thing, went back to breast and a flip turn and a full pull down. 16 miles, it's kind of a long way. And in long course, it's a long way. People are going, well, they go 4 miles fly straight? Yep, it went 4 miles fly straight holding the stroke. She started out when I first started working with her. Her name was Erica Fisher. She didn't have a lot of speed, a lot of talent, but she had a great talent to train. And she started out with a 103 and 100 freestyle. And by the end of the year, a year later, she won the 1,000 at Junior Nationals. So you get the idea how motivating this potentially can be. You have to be able to cycle it. You'll know if you get it wrong. If you get it wrong, don't kick yourself. It's like, you know, you go a set, and their best of 2019 was 117, and they have a day where they average 122, and you're like, what in the world? Well, it's you, probably, if it's the average of the whole group. And it might be them. Might be, you know, they went out and had a beer that night or something. You know, you don't know what these swimmers are doing. I once had Dr. Ernie Miglischko tell me that my critical velocity set in here was more accurate than lactate testing, because in college swimmers, you just never knew what they were doing in terms of their sleep and everything, but you knew that it was just at least as accurate. So, but you will be able to tell, you know, kind of a lot more if you track too. So this makes you better. It makes them part of the process. In this case, what we added was a predictive set. So 3 100s breaststroke on holding 109 predicts a 218. Now that's what we're saying. We're doubling this 3 100s on three, and we pretty much think that they're going to be really close to this time. Now you've got swimmers that are going to be better meet swimmers, and you got swimmers that drive you crazy. They leave it in the warm-up. They leave it in the either the warm-up pool, but usually in the training pool. And they'll drive you crazy. They drive me crazy. It does happen. I'm going to stop this for a minute. But in general, we can pretty much predict that the next week they'll do a 218, and you'll check this and check their best time in the 200 breaststroke, and if it's a 215, then they have to kind of think about, hey, am I working hard enough in practice? Or is this breaststroke and it's harder to do because the start's that important and breaststrokers tend to drop off more than, you know, whatever. But whatever you think, but at least you have something to know and go, okay, before the last meet, when you went 220, you averaged 109s and that predicted a 218. Now you're going 107s. Let's say they do it now and you go in here and you change this and you go 107s colon 07.00. And then you can see that their improvement rate is, we must have gotten something wrong. Yeah, I put exclamation point. 1:07.00, and let's see, Excel will like that better there. And they've dropped 14%. And now you say, okay, now you're predicting a 214, maybe you'll go a 216, which will be okay because the, you know, junior national qualifying time is blah, blah, blah. And you're having this conversation with your swimmer, and it's something where you connect your practices with the meets so intimately that that it's really cool. And in fact, they might even ask for something and go, that didn't work. And you can interact with each other that way. There are times when people will go the opposite direction, etc. But you'll be able to see that. This is a really long sheet. As you can see, we did a lot of things, and it tends to be me to do that. I want to show you really quickly how to move and copy sheet so that you can mess around with this without messing up the one that you already have that you like. So all you go is, I think it's to edit. Yes, move or copy sheet. There it is. So you can move it to the end, create a copy, and go, okay, now that changed, that made all your formats exactly the same. You didn't have, when you copy and paste, it doesn't work this way. So made all, it kept all the formats the same as this one, and then you could mess with this one all you want, change it, change these times, put the change the American records, or whatever you want to do, change this to long course, whatever you want to do. So coaches, this is a beginning. Notice one of the first things I put in here is attendance, so that I can be able to tell somebody, hey, you know, see how you're not improving as much as everybody else? You're only coming 70% of the time. I have found, though, that some of my sprinters have improved more because they've come less, and so that tells me I may be overdoing them a little bit. And I'm looking for things like that. I don't necessarily always tell the swimmers that, but I'm always looking for ways or reasons that people will come to more percentage of the workouts. So this is the first thing I put. This is the group that they were in. This is the age that they are, and that can be calculated through Excel, et cetera. Again, this will be a lot more automated, and so in the software Cool Coach 5, it'll be a lot more obvious in some of the other software that's out there and that Bridger will tell you about. But I like to leave this wide open for you to make changes, and I really love it printing on one sheet that you can put up on the wall, or one sheet that you can put in the newsletter and show not only the improvements in times, but all the elements that go into people going faster. Swimming faster is fun. Never leave a wall without a goal. And remember me, I'm Steve Friederang. I'm the CEO of CompetitiveSwimmer.com. See me at my website. Bridger and I have an app called Competitive Swimmer that's free. And make sure you get that. Make sure you subscribe to Competitive Swimmer magazine. And we're out there. If you need me, I'm Steve at CompetitiveSwimmer.com. You can email me directly. Well, I'm looking forward to hearing from you, and looking forward to hearing your success stories.